everybody, welcome back, youtube.com/geekaloud for another Let's Install. Today, Exoprimal by Capcom, and we're installing it today as it was recently released and included in Xbox Game Pass as a day one inclusion. Now, I'm relatively sure I hit the install button. I'm not sure. There we go, viewing queue. That's what I was actually after. Here we go, viewing in queue. Okay, I can tell you, Exoprimal, Amir, what are we at this point? I want to say 5 days post-release. So I would assume it's version 1.0 or somewhere thereabouts, and I can tell you that that is 45.84 gigabytes. Now, what is Exoprimal? It is an online team co-op shooter in which you're hunting dinosaurs. That's right. If you've ever watched Jurassic Park and thought, man, I'd like to shoot some dinosaurs, maybe Exoprimal's one you want to check out. It is, of course, team-based online. So if you've got a couple of friends, this one should definitely be on your radar. Speaking of friends and on your radar, put the Gaming Enforcement Agency on your radar because, baby, we're back Thursday night, 8 p.m. right here on Geek Aloud. It'll be myself, Bully, and Ace filling in for Unky Dunky as he'll be hard at work. But we will be back for the Gaming Enforcement Agency, episode 74, this Thursday night, 8 p.m. right here live on Geek Aloud, or you can always watch it after the fact on Geek Aloud as video on demand. Alternatively, that's right, it's an audio podcast, so you can get it on any audio podcast service of your choice. But today's Exoprimal install will be discussed then in full detail. So come back in a couple of days and you can check out our full hands-on thoughts. But for today's install of Exoprimal note, it's going on to an Xbox Series X, as I said, 45.84 gigabytes coming in. And it's not here for me, but in case you've never heard me supply the tip before, sometimes there'll be a third button next to it'll say cancel or pause, or sometimes there's a third button that says suspend my game. If that suspend my game button ever comes up, absolutely hit it, because it will it caps or limits your download speed. It crunches it. So if the option to suspend your game is there, hit that and the install will go up to 5 times faster. So highly encourage you to do that if that option's available. But for now, let's install Exoprimal. Oh, I should note on the other side of the install, of course, we'll jump into the game, we'll look at the main menu, I'll go through any options and make any recommendations for changes that we see in the main menu. And then, of course, we'll bounce on out to the Xbox dashboard and I'll give you the correct in current version number and the full and complete install size, as it will be different to the download size. We'll be right back after the install right here, youtube.com/geekaloud. installed Exoprimal. That's right, Exoprimal. Let's boot it on up now. Check out that main menu. Have a look, see if there's any options we want to change. Maybe some motion blur we'd like to disable. Maybe, who knows? We'll have a look. See, maybe there's a 40, 60 frames per second option. 40? 30. 30 or 60 frames per second option. Troy J, yeah, go ahead and sign me in. It said it was a Capcom game. I wonder if it'll tie into some sort of overall Capcom account. Surely such a thing exists. Brightness, standard fare. Yes, that displays. Right now, I always encourage everyone to set up your brightness and contrast and everything according to your monitor. Don't go by my settings. I've got two big studio lights in my eyes, so it'll change everything. Now, in-game subtitles, I want zero, thank you. Zero subtitles. Hide all, thank you. Main stories, subtitles, you can go away also. Speaker name, yeah, we can leave that on. Subtitle size, small. Next, speaker, home theater. I wish, no, we have stereo headphones will be the best option for me. Once again, take the time to set it up for you. Audio output is fine. 3D audio is off. Yep, all fine. Creating, save data. I definitely agree to whatever all this nonsense says. Once again, I'll ask the question, why can't I agree to Xbox's terms and then have the games publishers agree to Xbox terms and then I'd never have to see the game developers' lists? Wouldn't that be a great idea? We could just jump in after our initial setup of a console. How exciting would that be? A very straightforward process that I think they should hurry up and prioritize and implement, but maybe we'll have to wait for the next generation of consoles for something like that to come on. Add-on obtained. I haven't purchased a thing. The only thing I've got is this through. We're going to go ahead and skip the cutscene as this is a let's install, not a let's play. Definitely. Where is it? I want the main menu, please. B to skip. Push and hold B to skip. Main menu, please, is what we really want here so we can dive on into those settings and work it out. Oh, look at this. Here we go. Straight into the tutorial, but the all-important settings. All right, here we go. What have we got? Gameplay, sprint. Does it have an auto sprint? Double input. Tap, tap. Nah, I'll leave it as default then. Hold, look down scope. Yes. Subtitles is hide. All that standard there. Network. Now, does it have crossplay? I've got crossplay on. I don't know if this is a Xbox exclusive, so maybe crossplay is just for the PC. Or maybe it's out on PS5, I'm not quite sure. Anyway, controller mapping. We can remap stuff there. Dead zones and such, but I'm not seeing anything worth changing there. The old map, that's always good to look at, but nothing else worth changing there. Let's jump over to video and have a look. Display area, brightness, HDR. As I said, take the time to set it up for yours. Don't go by mine there, but I would set it up accordingly. Voice chat, I'll leave it on as it is an online multiplayer game. Typically, I'd turn it off. Like, if it was Call of Duty, I'd say just turn it off. However, I believe teamwork's important here, so we'll leave it on, but nothing else there worth changing. The final one is display. What have we got? First, direct your attention to watch. Display. All that seems quite fine. What have they got in the accessibility tab for us? Camera shake. Go ahead and turn off camera shake if you're susceptible to motion sickness, because that will not be helping you at all. Communication log text, just the size of that, that's fine. Blood splatter on, yes please. Blood splatter red, yes thanks. All right, there you have it. That is the settings in Exoprimal that we recommend you set up here. So let's bounce on out now, pull up the particulars, and wrap up this install. I can tell you, Exoprimal, 5 days post-release, is currently version 1.0.11.0, and that is a full and complete install size of 45.8 gigabytes. Thank you very much for watching another Let's Install here on Geek Aloud for our full hands-on, in-depth impressions of Exoprimal. Come back Thursday night for the Gaming Enforcement Agency. We're back this week for episode 74. There's been a month off, but we're back. It's myself, it's Bully, and it's Ace this Thursday night. It'll be fantastic to have you in that live YouTube stream, chatting along with us. Any comments if you've played the game yourself, or any questions if you haven't, they're always welcome. As I said, live stream, so that's real-time interaction. What else can you do with Geek Aloud? Like it, subscribe it, you'll never miss it. Oh, that was luck.
Dookie.
Dookie.